Hello, Ananya, Ananya, you can start.
Yes, sir. I'll start. Greetings to everyone, and welcome to the Guest Lecture Series 2020, an initiative by Technovanza VJTI. This lecture is co-hosted by Gaya College of Engineering and Engineering College, Ajmer. This is Ananya Pawar, and I'm thrilled to be your host for today. VJTI was established in the year 1887, and it's upholding its proud legacy of over a century filled with brilliance and educational prowess. Furthermore, it has thrived in nurturing the brightest minds of the society. Technovanza has always been the prime platform when the fame of expertise has been meritoriously passed on to light more torches. The renowned lineup of the guest lecture series over the years has added immense values to the lives of several young minds, pioneers of diverse fields, including Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Dr. A.S. Kiran Kumar, Mr. Ratan Tata, Dr. John Mather, and many others have graced Technovanza with their presence. Amplifying this extraordinary legacy, we are very proud and gracious to host a very great Indian scientist who has worked mainly in waste management and also known as Plastic Man of India, the phenomenal Dr. Rajgopalan Vasudevan. Is currently a faculty at the Thea Garjar College of Engineering and is an accomplished scientist. Sir believe that plastics carry the key, eliminate the potholes while also recycling plastic instead of dumping or incinerating them. He is famous for devising an ingenious method to reuse plastic waste, which helps in construction of cost-effective and durable roadways. This idea came as a boon for villages who now have access to better transport facilities in the remotest areas due to these better. A totality of 11 states across.
Audio is not there. Or audio is not all right.
Hello.
Please proceed.
Is it okay now?
Please proceed.
A totality of 11 states across India have used this technology to build more than 1 lakh kilometers of roads. Sir was awarded the Padma Shri in 2018 for his unmatchable work. Sir, this small introduction wouldn't do enough justice to you. You have blended the eloquent qualities of hard work and persistence with absolute sublimity, which can never be unseen. We are truly honored by your presence today. We will have a Q&A session after the lecture, so please leave your questions in the live chat below. Sir will be sharing his expert outlook on the topic, Plastic, a Gift of God. So without any further ado, let's be a part of conversation talking about our shared future under the guidance of Clearly the Best. Over to you, sir.
Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om. Thank you very much. Though I was a bit late in appearing before you due to some electronic problem, I'm really happy I'm here to share some of my ideas. Wonderful. I specifically gave a topic here as Plastic, God's Gift. Let us try to understand first the creation concept. What Bhagavad Gita says, Saga yajna praja shushta puro vacha prajapatihi anena prashavshitam yesha vo ishta kamatu devan bhaveda de devo bhavyantaha parasparam bhavyantaha sreha pravsaha. This is the science of living. This is the science of creation also. God says, I have created you along with the world, and you live together with them, and by living together and by being friendly to the nature, you prosper and you achieve greater height. So this is the science, this is the philosophy, the way of life. So we need to live as a friend to the nature. And all our life, all these years, past several thousands of years, were based upon this concept. We are living together with the nature. There was no problem of environmental hazards or global warming. Nothing came like that. But suddenly, we had World War I and World War II. After the World War, before World War, since Ramayana, the age of Ramayana up to the World War II, people are following the concept of basic living concept, dharma. I call it dharma of life, dharma of living, dharma of how to live in this world. But once the World War finished, there is a rush for technological development. More and more of industries. Now we are now industry number 4. More and more of industries are being developed. And there's a rush from villages to from the urban locality. Urban development was there. How the urban development take place? It is more by deforestation. It is more by grabbing cultivable lands and so on. More than you are able to develop industry or develop into housing colony and so on. You know what I think? But all those things has got a lot of effect on your environment. On one side, you are trying to grab the forest, land, etc. Deforestation take place. You are middling with the environment. The other side, when you develop the world, the structure, your industry, you need to have more and more of structural materials. What are the structural materials normally we use? We use wood, we use iron, we use copper for electrical appliance, we use mirror, we use glass, we use many, many such material whose demand were going on increasing day by day. When that demand comes out, man start exploiting the nature. He start more and more, to get more wood, deforestation take place. Therefore, all those things created an environmental hazard. Edhaidah dharmasya klanit bhavadvarda, abhyuktana madharmasya tadatman sujyamegam. God always tried to save. Maintaining the equilibrium is very important. So what God felt is, now the need of structural material is important. Let me try to introduce a new material that is called plastic. A plastic came into existence in 1950s and 60s. It substituted wood. It substituted iron. It substituted glass. It substituted adhesives. Many of the structural materials are all from plastic. One plastic material is able to bring out so many things. And there is automatically the nature's material was not in demand and we are using them. So this become a beautiful substitute. It's a God's gift to for us to make use of those things. Thereby, you have a better standard of living. At the same time, you can help the nature by without disturbing it. So we were living. Therefore, plastic becomes a very handy. It has become poor man's friend, common man's need, and household people is a necessity, and rich man's identification. And most of the, now we are talking about plastic car. So everywhere you think about plastic, starting for your ballpoint pen to any industry, you have a plastic. So plastic spreads itself everywhere. In every form, from carry bag to machinery material, plastic spread. So plastic is so much important. How do you say plastic is a waste? What is the drawback of this plastic? There is no drawback of the plastic at all. People say the plastic is not biodecomposable, therefore it is a problem. No. Please think about it. Your stone is not biodecomposable. Do you ban the stone? You use it for construction. The glass is not biodecomposable. You use for construction. Gold is not biodecomposable. You use it for ornaments. There are many materials which are not biodecomposable, as you expect. But God has fixed a date for everything when it has to decompose. So plastic has got a long duration, that's all. But why do you bother about it? But plastic has got a beautiful property. What is a beautiful property? When the plastic melts, it becomes a beautiful adhesive. Let us try to understand more about that. But what we do now is, without knowing about all those things, without knowing the importance of the plastic. And you know, your friend indeed, in friend indeed, you know, plastic is a great friend, but we only dispose it. Of the 84 lakhs living beings, only 1%, the human being, creates problem in the world by disposing plastic indiscriminately. He throws it everywhere. His disposal technique is, his garbage culture is bad. And because of that, they clog the water path. Because of that, you have all the problem. Plastic by itself is not toxic. Plastic by itself is not a problem. It is a man-made problem. These fellows, they travel in the sea. They are in the seashore, and sea debris has increased. How can plastic can go to the sea unless these fellows throws it? And you know what is the most important sea debris in sea debris? It is cigarette butts. How cigarette butts can be seen in the seabed? Do you mean to say fish is smoking? No, it is a human being create the problem. We only throw the waste material on the seabed. We only throw on the land. It is a human being problem. Therefore, plastic is not a problem. Therefore, I say plastic is a God's gift. Not only that, the God has given a wonderful material, not only for construction like that. It has, now as I told you, plastic, it is very light. It is very cheap. And the transportation becomes easy, machining becomes easy, manufacturing technique becomes easy, fabrication becomes easy. So many processes, cost-wise less, energy-wise less. So plastic consumption of energy is less. Therefore, it is a very useful material. Therefore, plastic, again, I want to stress the point, plastic is not the problem. The problem is human being. He only disposes indiscriminately. He uses it. But see, I used to say normally, the industry manufactures the plastic and market it and forget it. We, the people, consume the plastic and use it and throw it, forget it. The government collects the plastic, dumps it and forget it. If you do that way, if you don't use your own responsibility, if you are careless and careless about yourself, what will happen? All the problems comes. It is not the problem of the plastic. It is your carelessness and your carelessness. You are careless about yourself. You are careless about your country, your own environment. Therefore, think about your own where you want to see very important. You have to own. It is your responsibility to keep the environment clean. Therefore, on one side, you need to keep the environment clean. On the side, you have wonderful material which you are simply throwing away. Why I say wonderful material? Now I will come to my technology, what I have done. Very simple. See, in 2001, people are planning to ban plastic. But I could see, I could get the information in Tamil Nadu, more than 7,000 industries were working in plastic. 1 lakh people were working, so they will be out of job. So we must do something for them. So I tried to do something. They said then plastic is only a product from, obtained from the bitumen. It's a product from the petroleum. So petroleum, bitumen, plastic, they belong to the same family. Why not? Well, plastic can be mixed with the plastic, with the bitumen, and find out the chain. And to my surprise, plastic get mixed with the bitumen, and the mold and the polymer modified bitumen has got a better property. It is improved property. I thought, why not? Why not we use it for using the polymer modified bitumen for road construction? Fortunately, I had a great blessing of our late president, APJ Abdul Kalam, who came and saw this. Vasudevan, it's a wonderful work. It should be developed in a scientific way and do it. One day you will be given due recognition and award. His word came through. He is Vasishtravayal Brahmarshi. He is a person who predicted, and it came true. Today, I'm Plastic Man of India. People call him as Plastic Man of India, and government has given for the small work, but must all those things, because a simple work, but it's a useful work. What I have done? Very simple. The plastic is useful as a binder. When plastic melts, it becomes a molten material and acts a beautiful binder like araldite. So what I do is, simply, in road technology, I use plastic. What is road technology? You take the stone, heat it to 170 degree, add bitumen, mix it and lay the road. So bitumen is a binder and stone is bound together and the road is laid. This road, if you done scientifically correctly, it will long last for 2 years. But here's the problem. Whenever there is a rain or water stagnation, water penetrates and there creates potholes. Once potholes form, road is spoiled. So cracks are developed. Therefore, this is a basic problem of bitumen road. Now, what I now thought was, take the same stone, heat it 170 degree. Now, take the plastic, shredded plastic, your carry bag or your multi-layer biscuit cover or your chocolate cover, anything. You see here, I'm just showing for your reference. This is a plastic which is all the plastic which is shredded like small pieces and shown. And these plastic are spread over the stone, hot stone, and it gets melted and coated and stone becomes laminated by plastic. Now add the bitumen. The bitumen now acts a beautiful binder. And now, interestingly, the plastic has a binder between the plastic and the bitumen. And it binds both bitumen and stone strongly. And not only that, water never penetrates because water plastic will not allow. So no pothole formation. So simply take the stone, heat it 170 degree, add the plastic, shredded plastic, whose size 2 to 4 mm, shredded plastic, and coat the stone with the plastic, add the bitumen, 30 seconds extra, you get a beautiful mixture, and mixture you use it for road lay. The road laid has got life doubled in strength. We laid the road in 2002, now we are in 2020, the roads are still wonderful, no crack developed, no pothole form, more than 15 years. So the road's quality is good, capacity, strength, road standing capacity is good, and you don't need a maintenance work for 15 years. It saves a lot of money. And for a simple 1 kilometer road, if you want to lay, normally we use 10 tons of bitumen. Now we use 9 tons of bitumen, 1 ton of plastic. 1 ton of plastic means 10 lakhs carry bag. 10 lakh carry bags is put in 1 kilometer. And the road, so cost wise, bitumen is 60,000 rupees. Plastic is 10,000 rupees. You save the money. And the road is 15 years, it stands. No maintenance cost at all. So cheaper material. And the plastic finds a wonderful use. And environment friendly, we use only to 170 degree. It only makes no gases produced. Environmental friendly. Better road. Disposal plastic become easy. And you know, India has got 46 lakhs kilometers of road. If all the roads are converted into plastic road, I need not less than 150 to 200 lakhs tons of plastic. India has got only 10 lakhs. The disposed plastic available 10 to maximum 10 to 15 lakhs. What do you need? 200 lakhs. All the disposed plastic can be very well used for road laying. No problem at all. Disposal of plastic is not problem. So there's a beautiful technique available. Very many countries are demanding this technology. I said, I'm giving to my country. Though United States offered me $300 million, I said, I'm giving to my country only freely, and I have already given. In more than 11 states have implemented this technology. 1,50,000 kilometers road have been laid. Border roads are being laid now. So the technology is very simple and very easy, therefore very useful. And the plastic, and it's here, we use all type, we're all films. Films, the thickness up to 70 micron. It can be monolayer or it can be multilayer, and wonderful, the roads are beautiful. And the road strength also very good, and therefore there is no problem with the spread. And you can now lay your rural road 24 lakh kilometers, you can lay and then convert them beautifully and make the villages smart village by giving a better road. So the technology is very simple, and we are able to get a wonderful technology for disposal of waste plastic, and environmental friendly also, no problem. So the only aspect here is the plastic helps or a binder. It melts and binds. That's all. That property I use. You know, I have developed this technology still more further. I take the same stone. Now, normally in the road construction, for 1 kilometer stone, I use 45 grams of bitumen, 5 grams of plastic. 1 kilo to 1 kilo weight of stone needs only 5 grams of plastic to get a beautiful work like this. But now what I do is, the same stone is taken, add more amount of plastic, so that taking only plastic and stone, no bitumen, no sand, no cement, no water. Mix only plastic and stone and you prepare a product called, this is plastone. Now this mattress has got plastic and stone only. This can withstand 300 tons load. This is 10 times stronger than concrete. And you can construct a house, small cost, low cost toilet, low cost housing. And this plastone can be used for fiber blocks, for road on both sides, and compound wall, and flooring. Many things it can be used. And here, the use of plastic is about nearly about 50 to 100 times more than the road. And the India is now planning to construct 2 crores of toilet, which means I need 1 crore ton of plastic. Even for the road laying, we don't have plastic. That is the case. Where will go for this? Therefore, plastic is wonderful material. We have many products. Now I have developed another product called hollow blocks. So plastone, hollow blocks, tabletop, like that. Plastic is a very useful material, and this is going to give a better road, better conveyance for a house construction, beautiful finish. I have developed, this is what I called synthetic granite. Cheaper, it is 4 to 5 times cheaper than granite, but better than granite in its strength. Therefore, a wonderful material is available. So why do you bother about the plastic? Plastic is not decomposing, it should be banned. No, collect the plastic, very important. Now, how to do that? What is the problem? When plastic is useful for everybody, now after that, even dispose it properly and collect it, it is useful for road, for plastone, for so many things. Then what is the problem? The problem is only, again comes to us only. What we do? We don't collect the plastic, we don't segregate, we don't collect the product and separate it properly. If you could collect the product separately, you can use it for road. Kerala government has done a wonderful work, Kerala Clean Corporation. They collect the plastic. Last year they have laid 1,000 kilometers of road using 12,000 tons of plastic. So it is possible. So what to do? First, on the domestic level, people has to create awareness among the domestic people to separate plastic and keep it separately so that it can be collected somebody by somebody. So this awareness to be created, and that is very important. And that process, what I do is, I go to the school, talk to the students and request them, why not you bring the plastic? Why not to bring the plastic? And they bring the plastic and give it to the school where they collect it and give it to the road construction. It is very easy. Every house there is one student at least. And he can clean his house and beautifully it can lay the road. No problem at all. So that can very easily we can do this work. It can be effectively done. So awareness among the domestic people is very important, and that can be done, you can very easily collect it. Number two, the hotels, community hall, they must also have responsibility to collect and give it. Number three, the manufacturers, plastic manufacturers. The manufacturers should have a responsibility. They live because of the plastic only. Without plastic, they cannot live. Therefore, it is a bounden duty of them to join in the move to collect the plastic and give it for your effective use. They may use a payback system, or they may use some adaptation of some street and like that. Collect the plastic and give it to the people concerned. Very important. The manufacturers got a very important role. The government is facilitating them from giving so many concessions in the process. But still, the manufacturer should take greater role. The government, of course, when I met our honorable Chief Prime Minister in 2015, when I was awarded Tech Icon Award, I talked to him for a few minutes. I told him about the plastic road. Prime Minister said, "I know about it. I will implement it." I had a meeting on October 2nd, November 9th. I could see the government notification. Here was the only plastic road to be laid. And my technology has been accepted. IRC coding has come. And therefore, the coding is done. Government is ready. Government notifications come. And therefore, what is the difficulty in using the plastic for road? Technology is accepted. The Pollution Control Board has accepted. That's only human mind is very important. The people who are on the higher hierarchy, this mindset is important. They must try to know plastic road is good. Plastic is environment friendly. There is no problem. People ask, what will happen? The water will not go inside. No, the road, the center road, no plastic need to go, no water need to go. Therefore, this mindset only important. If you use, then there won't be any problem. So the government should have the responsibility. That's why I say, not to ban, but to plan. The planning is how to collect the plastic, used plastic, by domestic people as well as by the help of the manufacturers and by the involvement of the government and the public, we can collect it. And I said, as I told you, the plastic available is very much less for the whole work. Therefore, there is no problem at all. Plastic can be very well used. And you know, now we previously are just talking about the plastic ban. Suddenly, COVID came. Why COVID came, I can say it is again God's will, because nature was disturbed by the human being. So they were the global warming taking place, and the monsoon were modified. So COVID, what is the effect of COVID? You know, COVID made all the man to sit inside. It was house arrested, they were all, for 3 months, 4 months, and the nature rectified the atmosphere. And when they try to treat these COVID people, they need again plastic. PPE is important. Plastic comes again very many form. So plastic is a friendly material, very useful material. It's a God's gift for various occasions, for various end users. No problem with the plastic. Let us try to understand the importance of plastic, and let us understand our carelessness and carelessness about the environment, and let us try to know India is great, and we have got Swachh Bharat, we have got Make in India, and simple technology which I have developed, the country recognized it and awarded me a Padmasri. So the younger generation should understand, we need to work for the country, we need to develop more things for the country. I am not interested very much going in Mars or going in some other place. Let us, India has got 65,000% of village people. We must try to work for them. We must try to improve their standard of living. We must try to improve their way of living in every respect. For that, definitely plastic and other material can be used. And you know, industry has got very many waste. Now the industry development goes on, and you have every industry has got a solid waste. Well, how to dispose it? A solid waste limestone, a solid waste like bakelite, a solid waste like concrete, a solid waste ceramic waste. Again, we have developed a technology where we can find a use for all those things also. Solid waste disposal becomes very easy. So plastic helps to have better road, plastic helps to have better house construction, better structural material, plastic helps to have a better environment also, plastic helps, don't burn the plastic, it only creates only carbon dioxide. So it is useful every respect. So let us say that God has given a best material for us so that we can live happily in this world using the plastic. One thing is, think about how to dispose it properly. How I can be useful to the world? How I can be useful to myself? Not only if you are useful to the world, means you are useful to yourself only. Service and sacrifice is a way of life. Let us serve the nation by collecting the plastic, by segregating plastic, by trying to using the plastic. So domestic people try to collect, then the industry people should help, and the government should use the plastic for laying the plastic road. Even after 15 years, I come across certain bureaucrats who say plastic road is not good. Why? I don't know. They don't have any reason at all. Think about it. You can use it. Definitely, you can make a better India, better world, no problem. Therefore, I say plastic is God's gift. So, you know, I can only say, one of my rickshawala in Madurai, Rikshawala, he wrote in the backside of the auto, said, don't put plastic on road, use plastic for road. What a simple way he represents the whole technology. What a great message is given. Don't put plastic on road, use plastic for road. If we follow this technique, definitely the environment will be better. You don't have any problem. You have better road also, better atmosphere. Therefore, let us all join together to work for the betterment of the India, betterment of the world, and better environmental factor. Wish you all the best. Thank you very much for giving the opportunity. Anwar Pawar, come on.
Thank you, sir, for such an insightful lecture. I'm sure I'm speaking on behalf of the entire audience right now that you have positively revealed groundbreaking thoughts and promising ideas while instilling a new perspectives in our lives.
Please.
We'll now begin the Q&A session to answer a few of our audience questions.
Please.
Sir, so the first question is that generally it is observed that students find chemistry a little boring. It is not a go-to subject for them. So how did you develop interest in it? And similarly, how can you inspire students to develop their interest in it?
I couldn't follow you very much.
Okay, so should I repeat the question?
I'm not able to follow you. I'm not able to follow you, please.
Sir, generally students find chemistry a little boring. So how did you develop your interest in it?
Could you find anything? Please repeat slowly but loudly. I'm an old man now, please.
All right, sir. So, my question was that many students find chemistry a little boring. So, how did you develop your interest in it?
See, life is beautiful. Make it useful. What is the way for boring, you know? Every minute I'm enjoying. Even at this age, I'm enjoying the life and anything by doing something good. Even today, I went to the lab, I did a new product, I developed a new product. You know, plastic is not undergoing biodecomposition. I'm trying to develop a new technique for decomposing, number one. Number two, you know, we have a multi-layer plastic and that is not recycled. It can be reused only. That can be used for road. But why? What I say is, let us use it. But what is the need for a multi-layer? You want to protect the material inside. Instead of having a multi-layer, you can have multi-packets. You can have two packets or three packets, put the chocolate in the first packet, and that packet can be put another packet, which is a polymer, and then put it in a paper packet. Thereby, you can remove separately each one and then recycle it effectively. Once you have only laminated plastic, it's not a problem. So this technology will be developed. Therefore, there are many things to be developed. See, I say your cooker, the cooker which you use, efficiency only 50%. We have to modify the burner. We have to modify the cooker. Nobody does it for the past 50 years. We need to do a lot. There are many things that have to be done. Younger generation should think about it. Make them to think. Don't load them with subject. That's why our modern new education policy, somehow I like it because it gives more freedom for them to think hands-on. They must try to develop of their own. Many, many things I can cite many, many examples in my travel up to this place. There are many, many people who came and helped me like that. So like that, there is no question of boring. Only thing, getting. Knowledge is interesting. Any knowledge is interesting, whether it's spiritual knowledge or material knowledge. The more you know, better you are. How can there be boring? And that too, today you got your YouTube, you got internet, you got so many media. When I was studying, I didn't have anything like that. I have to run to library after library. Whereas when everything is sitting on one place, I can now enjoy power, I can enjoy the teaching, I can see the whole thing. So it's wonderful. So try to use all the facilities for your development. The man has got only one specialty, sixth sense, knowledge. All other living beings are much, much better than Indian man, human being. A dog is better, a cow is better. But only thing man is, how is better? He is a sixth sense. He can understand what is right and what is not. He can extend his love. He can find out God. Therefore, let me serve the world. Let me find out newer thing and serve the world and see God through service. Therefore, no question of boring at all.
That was truly an inspiring answer, sir. So the second question is, that in one of your interviews, I read that India doesn't have a large amount of plastic, which you need for making the roads. And also we know that Indian government emphasizes on using paper bags, cloth bags now, and has nearly banned plastic. So is there any alternative to plastic which can be used for construction of equally good roads as plastic roads?
No, in some cases, there is a why we need to ask such a question is the first most important. See, we wear gold. Is there any alternate for the gold?
No.
Gold has got its own importance. Like that, plastic has got a wonderful importance. Nothing can substitute plastic because all other things cost more. The plastic is the cheapest in the world. And plastic can be modified to any type of material. So, whereas when you go to any other material, you have a restriction in the availability. You have a restriction in the manufacturing. In the process of manufacturing, pollution is there. Therefore, what is the need for when things are available? Use it properly. The problem is you don't use properly. That's the problem. You say, I will be like that. I will not use properly. I will be careless and careless, but I want an alternate. No. Please don't think that. Let us try to understand. And there can be alternate but better material. So I don't say no. If it is useful, better. But here, poor man's friend, man. This plastic is poor man's friend. You visit any of the cottage, any of the huts there, they have plastic chair, plastic bucket, plastic mug, plastic mat. That is the one they can afford. How can they go? Can they go for a teakwood material? No. So plastic is given a better life. Therefore, don't think of an alternative. If you want to have alternative for any other purpose, for marketing, for example, jute? Jute is available in India. Use it. I don't deny it. But it has got its own restriction. Find a proper use for jute for making one. You don't think jute can be a competitor plastic. It cannot be. Because a jute bag cannot be equivalent to plastic bag. If you use cement and jute bag, you lose 2 kilos. In plastic, you don't lose anything. Like that, there are so jute can be used for something attractive things. Use it like that. Therefore, the very question is there any alternative? Why God has given a beautiful alternative to you? God's gift is, can you say God is doesn't know anything about it? Therefore, he has given a best alternative. You want to give a better alternative than God? Which is not possible. God is more intelligent than us.
Absolutely. Thank you for the insightful answer, sir.
Thank you very much.
What is the process to collect such large amount of plastic?
Pardon?
What is the process to collect such large amount of plastic?
Plastic collection.
Yes.
That's why I told you, domestic people awareness to be created. You must involve everybody's mind, no? The mind, whenever you see plastic, see, you try to keep it separately. And you can use younger generation, equip them intellectually. Plastic is useful. So that generation will grow properly. And this is very easy. I did it in Calcutta. I went to the conference. I said students can come. 1 lakh students came and they collected plastic and gave it. In Madurai, I used 35,000 students for collecting plastic. So very easily, motivate the younger generation. Create awareness in the old people. Motivate the younger generation. Make the industries to involve in the process. Government people should understand to serve the country. The people in the government should always feel, I must serve. So that is very much. The government is only to serve. Whereas when I'm a teacher, I want to serve the people. When I go to the classroom, I want to make the student to understand everything properly. I'm not going to think about my salary. I think about the knowledge for him. Like that, government should always try to help to use. Therefore, you got Swachh Bharat, you got Atma Bharat, you got Make in India. Try, get yourself involved. Opportunities are there. You can do more, no problem.
Absolutely. Right, sir. Sir, moving on to the next question. So, is there any specific grade of plastic you use or you prefer for better outcomes?
No, all your carry bags.
Okay.
Polyethylene, polypropylene, polystyrene, foams, films.
Okay.
PVC cannot be used. PVC is used for some other purpose. I am using PVC for something else. But these three can be used. These three occupies 55% of the packing. Therefore, we can use it. These films only we use. Film thickness up to 70 micron we use. We shed it to 2 mm to 4 mm and use it. And all types of plastic can be used here. No problem. Therefore, I need to, I want to only get the plastic, dry it. I don't want to clean it. Collect the plastic, dry it, shed it, give it for road. Nothing more than that.
Thank you, sir.
So all your waste plastic, which you see on the roadside, which is eyesoring to you, please think, aha, this should be converted into road. When you see any plastic, your mind should say, hey, here is a plastic available to convert into road. Here is a plastic available to make into plastic. Let us do. Let us make a move like that. Your power should immediately collect at least 10 of your friends. Come on, let us try. These 10 friends should again made 100 friends. And like that, we can spread the message to collect the plastic and use it for the betterment of the country. I feel that way.
Truly, sir. Truly inspiring.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
So we are honored by your presence and thank you for the impactful and thought-provoking session. We hope you all enjoyed the session.
I try to use as many opportunities possible to pass on the right information to the younger generation. So this is our life is depends upon the younger. The next generation is very important. Knowledge is available. Take it. I used to say differently. I sit on a chair. Below that, there is a gold mine. Below that. Without knowing that, I beg, please give me something, please give me something. If you open, you remove the chair and then open the door, you will have gold mine. Like that, India has got everything, every rich is available. I don't look into India, I look at some other country. And how best I can get it from there? No, see your India, see it's got everything. India is the best country in the world because environmentally India has got all facilities. It has got beautiful mountains, it has got beautiful rivers, it has beautiful land, all varieties of beautiful, moderate temperature. So everything is fine. Use this condition for the development. Be happy to be in India. Therefore, be Indian, buy Indian, buy Indian. Anything prepared by Indian only must buy. Let us have be Indian, buy Indian, buy Indian. That should be the goal of life.
Truly, truly, sir. Absolutely.
Thank you, ma. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So the upcoming GLS will be held on 24th of October, 7:30 p.m. The speaker of which is Mr. Adam Chair, co-founder of Siri and former director of engineering at Apple. Stay tuned. I am Ananya Pawar signing off. Until next time, this is Technovanza VJDR.
I'm not able to follow. Your voice is very shrill, beautiful, but somehow that I'm not able to enjoy it. Please, 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 be short again, please.
Okay.